Hello students, in this video we will discuss about vaccine stories and the cold chain. First we will see what do you mean by cold chain. The cold chain, it is a system of storing and transporting the vaccine at a recommended temperature from the point of manufacture to the point of use. Cold chain means we have to maintain the temperature of the vaccine from the manufacture point to the point of use. What is the recommended temperature is 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Cold chain is needed to maintain viability and potency of the vaccine so that vaccine cannot be destroyed by maintaining the cold chain. Because some vaccines they are heat sensitive, some of the vaccines they are cold sensitive. So we have to maintain the cold chain to maintain viability and potency of the vaccines. Next point, OPV vaccine, it is the most heat sensitive vaccine. It should be stored at minus 20 degrees Celsius. So most heat sensitive vaccine is OPV, and what is the temperature for storage? Minus 20 degrees Celsius. Optimum temperature of cold chain is 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Vaccines like BCG, after reconstitution, that means after dissolving in normal saline, vaccines like BCG, OPV and measles, they are heat sensitive. That means when we are keeping them in the high temperature, the viability is destroyed, but can be frozen without harm. Vaccines like DT, DPT, hepatitis B and TT, these are less sensitive to heat and damaged by freezing. So these vaccines should not be freezed. Vaccines that must not be frozen, these are hepatitis A, HIB, whole cell killed typhoid vaccines. Now we will see heat sensitive vaccine. First, after reconstitution, BC is the most sensitive to heat, then OPV, measles, DPT, DT, hepatitis B and DT. This is a series of heat sensitive vaccine. Here BCG is most sensitive after reconstitution, otherwise OPV is the most sensitive to heat, and less sensitive to heat is DT or TT. Now we will see how we will store the vaccines in a refrigerator. The vaccines that should be kept in the freezer compartment, these are the OPV vials. The temperature for storage of OPV is 0 to minus 4 degrees Celsius. In the main compartment, of the fridge, kept in the top rack, that is below the freezer, where the temperature is 4 to 10 degrees Celsius, the vaccines that should be kept are BCG, measles and MMR. In the middle rack, the vaccines that should be kept DPT, DT, TT, hepatitis A and typhoid. And in lower rack, hepatitis B, varicella and the diluents, they are kept on the side of the freezers. So this is the way of vaccination, how we will keep in the freezer to maintain the cold chain. Now we will see the equipments of cold chain system. First is walk-in cold rooms or WICR. These are located at state, national and regional level. These are meant to store vaccine supplies for 3 months. Used to store the vaccine supply for 4 to 5 districts, and the temperature of walk-in cold room is 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Second are the deep freezer of capacity 300 liters. These are used for supplying at district level and the PHC level. At district level, 2 to 5 large deep freezers are there, and at PHC level, 1 small deep freezer is there. The temperature that is maintained in the deep freezer is minus 15 to minus 25 degrees Celsius. This maintained temperature for 18 to 26 hours. It is used for making ice pack and for storing the OPV and the measles vaccine, because these vaccines they are stored at negative temperature. Third is ILR, that is ice lined refrigerator. The capacity may vary, 300 to 240 liter capacity. ILR is having two sections, A and B. A is the bottom section where OPV and measles they are kept. That means the temperature of the bottom section it is lower. And B is the upper section where BCG, DPT, DT and TT vaccines they are kept. Both at district and PHC level, and the temperature is maintained in the ILR is 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Now we will see do for use of ILR and don't use for ILR. First we will see the do's. First, keep the equipments in a cold room away from the sunlight, at least 10 cm away from the wall, properly labeled. Use voltage stabilizer, defrost periodically, temperature should be recorded twice a day, and recording of the vaccine should be there. Do not use for ILR. Do not keep other vaccines not used in universal immunization program. That means only vaccines that are given under UIP that should be kept. No other vaccines should be kept in ILR. Do not open unnecessarily. Do not keep food drink items into ILR or deep freezer. Do not keep more than 1 month requirement at PHC headquarters, more than 3 month requirement at district level, discard vaccine which has expired, and do not disturb thermostat setting frequently. The fourth is domestic refrigerator. The temperature maintained in the domestic refrigerator is 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, and it is not recommended for universal immunization program. So how we are keeping the vaccines in the refrigerator? Above there are ice pack. Below the ice pack, OPV vaccine. Below the OPV, measles. Below measles, BCG, TT. After then, DPT and DT, hepatitis B. And on the side of the door, the diluent should be kept, and there should be a dial thermometer to check the temperature. There are some don'ts when we are using the refrigerator. No food or medical specimen. Fridge not in direct sunlight. Do not store vaccine for more than 1 month at PHC. Do not store vaccine in fridge doors or in solid plastic tray containers within the fridge. What are the do's? Safeguard electricity supply should be there. Additional supply if there is light breakage. Not more than 50% full. Place vaccines in clearly labeled plastic mesh basket. Defrost or calibrate fridge regularly and record the temperature twice a day. The fifth are the cold boxes. Cold boxes are supplied to the peripheral vaccination center. These are of different size, 5 liter to 20 liter, used for transportation of vaccine. Fully frozen ice packs are placed at the bottom and the side of the cold boxes, and vaccines are wrapped into the polythene bags and kept in between. The holdover time is more than 90 hours for 5 liter and more than 6 days for 20 liter cold boxes. The sixth is the vaccine carrier. They carry small quantities of vaccine, 16 to 20 vials, sub-center or sessional site. Scare box is made up of insulated material, and 4 fully frozen ice packs they are used to line the site and close tightly, working capacity of 48 hours. Next are the day carriers. They are used to carry small quantity of vaccine, 6 to 8 vials for nearby session. For example, OPV ke liye when we are going, day carriers or the carrier bags they are used. Ice pack 2, one at bottom and one at top, and working capacity of 12 hour. Ice packs, they contain water, no salt is added, and filled up to the marked level and freeze. Now we will see cold chain monitoring equipments. There are 3 equipments for checking whether the cold chain is maintained or not. One is thermometer, second is CCM, that is cold chain monitor, and third is VVM, vaccine vial marker. The thermometers, they are of 2 types. One is dial type thermometer and bar type thermometer. Now we will discuss vaccine CCM, that is cold chain marker. So this is a strip over the vaccines, and it is written here over monitor mark indicator. There are 4 indicators that are given. Till A, B and C, the temperature is 10 degrees Celsius. Indeed, the temperature has come over to the heat, and after then it is refreezed, that is around 34. So the vaccine, if the A is blue, or if B is blue, C is blue, and if all are blue. For example, for the polio vaccine, if A is blue, use the vaccine within 3 months. and before giving the vaccine, test the vaccine whether it is expired or not. If measles and yellow fever, if B is blue, then use the vaccine. Till C, we have to use the vaccine till 3 months and use or test the vaccine before use. And if A, B, C and D all are blue, so do not use the vaccine. Test the vaccine before it is used. This is vaccine CCM. So this is a performa that we have to fill when we are checking whether the cold chain is maintained or not. So in that performa we have to fill when we have to open the vaccine, at what time, what is the date, and after then we have to fill that form. Third is vaccine while monitor. There is one circle, outside is the circle, inner is the square. If the inner square is lighter, inner is lighter, outside it is darker, use the vaccine. Second, if the inner square is lighter than the outer, use the vaccine. If the inner square matches or it is getting darker than the outer, then what we have to do? Discard the vaccine. So these are the cold chain monitoring equipments, how we are monitoring whether the cold chain is maintained or not. Thanks for watching. Do like, comment, share and subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. In the next video, we will see or discuss the questions related with immunization that were frequently asked in the competitive exams. Thank you.